Pharmaceutical giant Pfizer said that it will seek emergency authorization for its coronavirus vaccine within days, after reporting that its latest analysis showed that the vaccine is 95% effective at preventing illness and causes no major safety problems. The new data showed that the vaccine was 94% effective among people over 65, a group at high risk of serious illness, and prevented severe as well as mild cases. Apple will pay $113 million to settle an investigation by nearly 36 states in the United States into the tech giant's past practice of slowing customers' old iPhones in an attempt to preserve their batteries. The company's much maligned throttling efforts drew nationwide scorn when they came to light in 2017, stunning customers who at the time saw it was an attempt to nudge them into buying newer, more expensive devices. Three U.S. senators said that they would introduce legislation seeking to halt the Trump administration's effort to sell more than $23 billion of drones and other weapon systems to the United Arab Emirates, setting up a showdown with the president just weeks before he is due to leave office. Many lawmakers worry about whether the UAE would use the weapons in attacks that would harm civilians in Yemen, whose civil war is considered one of the world's worst humanitarian disasters. Iran said it would automatically return its nuclear commitments if US President-elect Joe Biden lifts sanctions, as the outgoing administration doubled down with more pressure. Biden has promised a return to diplomacy with Iran after four hawkish years under Donald Trump, who withdrew from a denuclearization accord and slapped sweeping sanctions.